The magic wand feature can be used for the creation of morph elements. This can be used on the floor plan, section, or elevation viewpoints. Simply space-click the nodes or edges of existing elements, and a new morph element will be created. The shape of the cursor will give you feedback during this operation to provide you feedback that the morph element was created. If the clicked point is part of an open geometry, morph edges will be created. If it's closed, a morph element will be created in the cutting plane of the given viewpoint. It's also possible to click within contours of elements, for example, a set of walls. The boundaries of the area will be found, and a morph face will be generated on it. In 3D, you can click the surface of any element and a morph face will be created based on the exact geometry of the clicked surface. Holes, solid element operations will be taken into consideration when creating the morph face. If you click element nodes or edges in 3D, the exact 3D geometry of the element will be duplicated and made into a morph element. In such cases, all the holes in the given elements, as well as solid elements operations performed on the element, are taken into consideration when creating a morph. In cases of walls, roofs, and shells, the geometries of the inserted windows, doors, and skylights will also be part of the created new morph geometry. Additionally, the magic wand may be used during the creation of a morph element. For example, when a revolution profile is created, the extrude path needs to be defined for the tube command. The magic wand can also be used to add edges or faces to an existing morph element.